Good morning, Ivan.
How do you do?
Listen, thanks an awful lot for doing this. You are a gentleman and a scholar and other things.
Yes.
You are, yeah, terrific.
I know who I am.
You know who you are. Okay. Okay, Ivan, how did you end up in Soho?
I had been working for Leo Castelli for a period of 10 years, 1959 to 1969. And it came to a turn where I decided that I should embark on my own enterprise. We lived on very good terms. We were very friendly and kind of a family situation with the son of Ben's and Leo. And I had been living at that time in the I.M. Pei Towers just down the street from here,
nice,
overlooking LaGuardia Place and West Broadway.
Right.
And I looked down on this neighborhood. And I, during that interval, I also walked through the neighborhood and found that it had a kind of remarkable physical unified quality about it, a unity of style.
Right.
Cast iron buildings that were in the classical arrangement. So I decided that it would be a daring and remarkable thing to evacuate from the golden belt of the galleries up on Madison Avenue and 57th Street and attempt to operate in what's called nothing. At that time, the only designation for this name was Hell's 100 Acres.
Hell's 100 Acres.
That was the usage for the late 19th, early 20th century when there were a lot of fires here in the neighborhood.
Uh-huh.
It turned out that people thought the cast iron buildings would be fireproof, but they weren't. The fires started inside the cast iron jacketing of the building acted as a kind of a chimney.
Uh-huh.
So fires were frequent and destructive.
Uh-huh.
So it came to be called Hell's 100 Acres.
Uh-huh.